a parent with little children comes here with their children so that they're free to walk around. They don't have to worry about traffic, about the danger of traffic. But now they have to worry about the danger of a terrorist popping up from God knows where and spraying them with bullets or rockets all of a sudden flying in.
When my son was four, the alarm was a word saying Shachar Adom. Shachar Adom in Hebrew means red dawn. But it sounds, when it comes out from a speaker, like the word Shachar sounds like Shachaf, which is the word sigil. When my son was four, he thought that the alarm that tells him to go and hide, saying red sigil. He thought it's red big metal bird that it's coming to take him. My son was four, and he was pretty much living in a Hitchcock movie. That was his reality. That was what he was thinking that life is, that you have to be careful from the metal birds.
Yeled agadol sheli ben 14, hayeladim yoter ktanim, vehem lo yodim aseh lihyot besheket, lo yodim aseh lihyot betzura yeled normali shekam, holech leshachek, velo mefached leshachek rachok mabayit, ki choshev sheyachol liyupol lo til.
I feel bad that I'm living in a place that there is a danger, a real danger to their life. I don't think children should live in a place like this.
I'm raising three kids here. Just behind us is one of the daycares, all of the daycares. We have 200 kids in preschool in the Moshav. Behind us you can see the shelter that we put on the roofs, which is supposed to not even stop the missile, but trigger it outside so it will not penetrate the ceiling.
When Peleg, my bigger son, was 5 years old, we go to my parents in the center, in Matan, and he go to sleep, read a book, and then he go to sleep. He ask, Mommy, when it start, what? The shooting. I say, there was no shooting over here. Why? I say, because we are not home. Why they don't shoot us here? And I don't have any clever answer. Then I realize that something is wrong. It's the moment that you say you don't want this life for your children.
A lot of times I find myself in the farm when the alarm goes off, and the first thing that I do, instead of looking for shelter, I run to the car to run back home and see where the kids are, because you always hear the explosion and you never know where it fell. And I have to see the kids. I have to see that they're all right. I have to know that they are not the victim these times. This little village, it's a very small village. We already lost 3 people to rockets. The rockets kill. If you are not in a safe place, the rocket will kill you.
You need every time, every second, you need to know where your children are.
אתה יודע שילדים לא רוצים לחיות, לישון לבד בבית, גם בתקופה כביכול שיש שקט. ילדים שנרטבים בלילה אחרי שהם בגיל, שכביכול כבר הפסיקו עם זה, שמפחדים ללכת לישון לבד.
How do you tell them that it's not safe? You don't want to scare them. They do want to live a normal life. But when they go out at night, I have to worry. And I don't want, on one hand, to send that worry to them, but on the other hand, I do want to keep them safe. And it's a question we have to deal with. I don't have an answer to that yet.
The children come back and they say they're afraid to come back. But when they get in and see our their beds and room, they say, Mommy, thanks. No place like home. We want to be here. Children say the truth.